Welcome back. In the previous lecture, we encountered KITPRA products for projectors. In this lecture, we will look at more general KITPRA products. So we have seen that there are these KITPRA products of vertical, vertical, and horizontal, and horizontal. If we add them up, we get the identity. Same for diagonal, diagonal, anti-diagonal, anti-diagonal, right-handed, left-handed, circle of polarization. In each case, we get the identity. But let's try to understand what these KITPRA products are. Okay, so they came about naturally or suggested very much by the formalism, but we need to take a closer look. So if we have a generic KITPRA, so with KIT 1 and BRA 2, and these are just labels that could mean either one of those or something else. And then we apply this KITPRA to another KIT. Then what do we get? Well, these are products, and as always when we have products, we can combine the factors any way we like. So here I put the KIT 1 aside, and I just multiply the BRA 2 with the KIT 3. So I here get a bracket, which is a number, and here I have a KITPRA, and that's not a number. The KITPRA is a new object. When applied to a KIT, it gives another KIT. So it maps a KIT onto a KIT. Well, what if I start with the KITPRA, but now I apply it to a BRA, and that naturally has to stand on the left. So again, I can multiply any way I like. So here we now combine the BRA 4 with the KIT 1 into a bracket, and we are left with the BRA 2. So here we have the KITPRA, the same KITPRA as above. But now it maps a BRA onto another BRA. So we apply the KITPRA to a KIT, we get another KIT. We apply the KITPRA to a BRA, we get another BRA. Now remember, KITs are numerically represented by columns of numbers. BRAs are numerically represented by rows of numbers. A KITPRA is numerically represented by a matrix. So if here we would have a matrix times a column, well, that's a column, right? So matrix, a column, gives a column. KITPRA times a KIT gives a KIT. Here we have a matrix multiplying a row to the left of that matrix. That gives another row. Row times matrix gives row. Matrix times column gives column. BRA times KITPRA gives BRA. KITPRA times KIT gives KIT. So these KITPRAs are objects that operate on KITs and give KITs, and they operate on BRAs and give BRAs. So that introduces the notion of an operator. So an operator is a KITPRA, or a sum of KITPRAs. Well, sums of KITPRAs, very simple sum of KITPRAs we have already seen, and the operator that we get as a result of this summation is the identity. So three different ways of writing the identity as the sum of two KITPRAs. So if we have KITPRAs and operator, if I know the operator, I don't know what is this sum, but if I know the sum, I know what it means. Right, so it's just like if I give you the matrix that represents the KITPRA or represents the operator, then you don't know how it is made up of simpler things. But if you know the simpler things and add them up, you know what you get. So we have brackets, which are numbers. So this is a number. This is a number. And this is an operator. And this is an operator. And the operators are represented by matrices fitting to the columns that represent the cats and the rows that represent the bras. Now, earlier when we were talking about manipulating polarized photons, we had matrices that represented V selection, H selection, the flipper, the do-nothing identity, and so forth. And we had also matrices for properties that we called Z and X and Y. And these matrices were 1, 0, 0, minus 1, and 0, 1, 1, 0, and 0, minus I, I, 0. At the time, we were just equating these symbols to the matrices, but now let's read them as being represented by the matrices. So the Z and the X and the Y, we now regard as operators that act on cats and bras that refer to polarized photons, represented by these matrices, but the matrices refer to the vertical horizontal basic alternative. So then what would be these operators? Well, let me remind you. When we have a column, then we convert this back into the corresponding cat by using the VH row of cats, multiply it with this column, and then this gives us the resulting cat, which is V times alpha plus H times beta, this particular linear combination of the V and the H cat, which is represented by this column. So we can begin with the cat and then decompose it into alpha, beta amplitudes referring to V and H, as we saw in a previous discussion. But now we are talking about how to go back. And what about rows? Well, if I have a row, say gamma delta, then that's converted into a bra by taking the row gamma delta and multiplying it by the column of the V bra and the H bra, which is just the adjoint of this row. So this would then be gamma V plus delta H. Now, if this bra is the adjoint of this one, then the gamma would be alpha complex conjugate and the delta would be beta complex conjugate. But this could also be some other generic bra. So columns, we work like this. Rows, we work like this. And what about a cat bra, or more generally an operator, which is a cat on the left times a bra on the right? So since we have the cat on the left, then we will have to multiply on the left with this column, with this row for the cat, and on the right we multiply with the column of the bras. So in the particular example of the Z operator, this is the matrix, and then what is going to be the operator itself? Well, everything refers to vertical horizontal in this notation. So we have the vertical horizontal row of cats, then we have the matrix representing the operator, and then we have the column of the bras, the adjoint of this row of cats. Now, as you work it out, this is V cat bra minus H cat bra. Okay, so here for the completeness relation, we have the sum. For the Z, we have the difference. Well, what about X? X is the V H row of cats, then we have the matrix, and then we have the VH column of brass. As we work it out, we get the VH cat bra plus the HV cat bra. So this one is the VH and this one is the HV. Finally, the Y. Okay, so this is the matrix. Put this matrix here. You will have the V minus I H and the H plus I V. Here and here. If we factor out the I, then we have the V H minus the H V multiplied by minus I. So these properties refer to the VH alternative, where we were assigning value plus 1 to V and value minus 1 to H. Well, you can see this here. This goes with plus 1, this one goes with minus 1. Then here for X, we were assigning plus 1 to D and minus 1 to A. That's not so obvious, right? And for Y, we were assigning plus 1 to right-handed circular polarization and minus 1 to left-handed circular polarization. Again, we cannot see that easily. All right, so Z is VV minus HH, and X should be diagonal diagonal cat bra minus anti-diagonal anti-diagonal cat bra. Okay, so how do we reconcile this with VH plus HV? Well, we need to express the D and the A in terms of the V and the H, but we know how to do that because we have the D equal to VH times 1, 1 and divided by square root of 2, and the A is VH 1 negative 1 divided by square root of 2. So the dA row of cats is the VH row of cats, and then 1 over square root 2, 1, 1 for D, and 1 negative 1 for A. So now I put this in here, and so here I have the A, and then the matrix 1, 0, 0, minus 1, and then the A. Well, I'm just repeating what I said before. The X operator is like the Z operator referring to the dA basis. So the Z operator refers to the VH basis. Now I take that matrix but make it refer to the dA operator, and that should give me X. So now we put in what we have here and use it there. So I'm now writing this as the VH, and then we have this matrix. 1 over square root of 2, 1, 1, 1, minus 1. Then this matrix follows, 1, 0, 0, minus 1. And then we have the column of brass, which is the adjoint of this row of kits, which is the adjoint of this product. So the adjoint of this matrix is the matrix itself. And then here we have the column of V and H. Alright, and so now we need to multiply these matrices and see what we get. The 2 square roots, that's just a factor of a half. Then this matrix times this matrix, we get 1 minus 1, 1, 1. because this one multiplies this column by one, and this minus one multiplies this column by minus one, and then we copy the other matrix, and now we multiply these and get a half of 0, 2, 2, and 0. So we get the flipper matrix again. And then for the X operator, this means that this V H ket bra plus H V ket bra, just like we had it over here. Okay, so indeed, the X operator is the DA version of the Z operator. Here we have VV minus HH, and here we have DD minus AA. And we can equally confirm that Y is the RL version of the Z. So this will be RR minus LL. So for the matrices, these Pauli matrices, remember, we now understand that these Pauli matrices are numerical representation of these Pauli operators. Which are operators that have eigenvalues plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, but for the different kinds of polarizations. Z for vertical horizontal, X for diagonal anti-diagonal, Y for right-handed left-handed circular polarization. In summary, all operators are sums of ket bras. When applied to kets, these operators give new kets. When applied to bras, the operators give new bras. All operators, such as the Pauli X operator, can be written in terms of ket bras that refer to the vertical horizontal alternative, or in terms of ket bras that refer to the diagonal anti-diagonal alternative, which are just two of very many ways. In the next lecture, we will address the question, how we calculate probabilities.